All right, folks, we are at the semifinal time of the Tokyo 2020 and 2021 Olympics in tennis, and there are four men left. Two of them make sense. Two of them, if you had told me in 2016 that Pablo Carreño Busta or Karen Khachanov were going to win a medal at the Olympic Games in 2020, I would have been like, you're pretty crazy. But nonetheless, the four of them are here and they are vying for the three medals left. Djokovic going for the Golden Slam still, looking amazing, has not dropped a set in the first four matches. So he's got two left. Can he beat Zverev and then win the final? I think this top half, Zverev Djokovic semifinal, is basically the final, but we're gonna get into these matchups, what they look like, and we're gonna figure out how to watch more of this tennis in Tokyo going forward, because it is a struggle for the folks here in North America on the West Coast. So let's get into it. Thanks for being here on The Slice. Welcome to the show. From the Delray Beach Open, Miami We are here with the man, Milos Raonic.
Welcome to The Slice.
All right, folks, thank you for being here and supporting the show. If you want to go to the website and get one of our pieces of merch, like the Bagel Time mug, which does help you statistically become a better tennis player, Milos Raonic endorsed, do that. Also head to theslicetennis.com for the new Canadian Corner. If you're Canadian, we post weekly articles there breaking down their action, giving updates, things that you little might not find out just from the general press, etc. So thanks for going to the website. There was a scheduling change due to the heat, but also due to the valiant efforts of Djokovic, Zverev, and Medvedev, who apparently all together went to the organizers and were like, look, it's way too hot out here. We have Fabio Fognini putting the air conditioning hose down his pants to cool himself. We just can't have that happening. We need to change the schedule. So they did that to help the players out, really, because it was just like insanely hot. So good on those three guys, led by Djokovic, to do that. Now, but that has moved the schedule back to even further back. So the matches start at 11 p.m. my time. So I'm going to be able to stay up tomorrow night for the Zverev Djokovic match, because it's one I've been waiting for the whole tournament. And that's the best matchup, I think, so far. I was waiting for Djokovic-Medvedev final, but that's not happening, because Medvedev lost to Pablo Carreño Busta, who I could, beforehand, I could have seen Pablo Carreño getting under the skin of Medvedev. Medvedev's been struggling with the heat. We've seen that. So that result kind of makes sense, but it's still kind of disappointing form from Medvedev after the French Open, which he overperformed at by winning a match, underperformed at Wimbledon, and again here at the Olympics. He's the number two player in the world for him. So as he said at the Wimbledon, you know, losing before the final basically is not a good result if you're the number two player in the world. So that's correct. I haven't watched any of the tennis at the Olympics live, except for a bit of Felix Auger-Aliassime. The Canadians are all out. That's why I'm wearing black. It's like a funeral for the Canadian dream at Tokyo 2020 Olympics. But, you know, it's hot there, and Canadians don't like heat. We're used to being up here, you know, frozen around in the snow. So that's our excuse. But anyways, let's get into these matchups, because I haven't been able to watch much like I've seen. I've been waiting for, you know, I can't stay up that late during the week sometimes. But now that we're in the finals, I'm going to be doing that for sure. Or the semifinals. So the first one is Zverev Djokovic, which is led 6-2 by Djokovic. Basically the final, like I've said, I think these are the two best players of the tournament by far. Whoever wins this probably will win the final and get the gold. It's kind of it's kind of shocking that one of these guys will get bronze or nothing. Last time they played was Australian Open 2021. And if you remember that match, that was a match where Zverev won the first set in a tiebreaker, and he was up a double break point in the second set, double break point in the third set, or might have been third and fourth sets. Anyways, he had the clear lead in that match for a lot of it, and he got tense. Classic Zverev, kind of choked it away a bit. Djokovic teed a racket absolutely hardcore, but that was one of the matches that really got Djokovic on the roll he's been on, obviously, so far in 2021. So this matchup is interesting because Zverev has the game to overpower Djokovic's defense. Djokovic has the game to obviously just make Zverev mentally implode and take away all of his weapons. So it's going to be another case of who plays better on the day. Looking at the stats from the last round, we got some interesting things here. Zverev against Shardy, who's obviously not one of the top players in the world, he only lost 4 points on his first serve in the whole match. So he almost served 80% first serves in. So that's huge serving from Zverev. He's going to need to keep that up if he wants a chance against Djokovic. But again, this is a three-set match, not a five-set match. That helps these younger guys who don't have the mental stamina to go five sets with the likes of Djokovic at this point. Djokovic in his last match versus Kenny Shikori, 6-2, 6-0, gave him the old bagel. It was a weird statistical match, though. I didn't get to see any of it. He only had 48% first serves in, but he did win all of his service first service points except for 3 points. So even better than Zverev there. But it just looked like a pretty like sloppy match from both guys, and somehow the score, and then the scoreline was just 6-2, 6-0 from Djokovic. But Djokovic is looking possessed in this tournament. He's looking absolutely motivated to win the gold part of his Golden Slam. So it's gonna, and this is his record third semifinal. Nobody else has ever done that, but he hasn't won one yet. So this is going to be a big match for him against Zverev, who is probably arguably his biggest competition in this tournament. So it's going to be a good match. It's going to be a tester. Again, another hurdle for Djokovic to hop over on the way to history. And you got to back him to do it because he's absolutely shown that he's the best player on planet Earth right now. A lot of people would say of all time, and he's just rolling. But as he gets closer to these records, the pressure does mount. And Zverev on a hard court in a three-set match is dangerous for Djokovic, for sure. Predictions, Djokovic winning, for sure. Definitely an upset possibility, though, because Zverev's done it before, and he has the game to do it now. Pablo Carreño Busta versus Khachanov, kind of a sleeper match. Honestly, not much intel on this at all from here. Pablo has the head-to-head winning record of 3-2 right now. Both guys could win. Both guys could choke. Both guys could lose. Not sure to what to expect here. Like I said before, the fact that one of them is going to get a medal at the Olympic Games is crazy. Not that I don't have faith in them. I like both these guys. Actually, no. I don't really like Pablo Carreño Busta. He's always rubbed me the wrong way. I think it's just the way he plays is kind of boring. And the bag incident against Nishikori where he was like chucking the bag, that just was whack. So I was not on board with that. Karen Khachanov was one of the brightest stars in the game, and he's kind of really slowed down. Remember, he beat Djokovic somehow at the Paris-Bercy final 2018 out of nowhere. He won a Masters 1000 there, and he's kind of slowed down since then, but he's a nice guy. So anyways, if I had to pick someone, I think Khachanov is going to come through the Pablo Carreño Busta match. He's actually played really well. He played good at Wimbledon, and he's in the semifinals here. I just think he's a better player, even though he's ranked lower right now. So I'm pulling for Khachanov, and I think he'll get through. Djokovic, I think he'll get through for sure. But we will have to see. That's why we watch these matches, which I'm going to try and do. So send me the links you've been streaming the matches on. I need to figure out how to watch it. It's going to be middle of the night here tomorrow night, but I'm up for it. Zverev Djokovic, going to be a great match. What's your predictions? Let me know down below. Thank you for being here on The Slice. Make sure you subscribe, like this video. It helps us out. Smash the like button. Like the video if you're a Djokovic fan. Like the video if you're a Pablo Carreño Busta fan. And we will see you next time here after the Olympics is done to give a full recap and a preview of the American Hard Court Swing, which we've actually already done on the Patreon channel, The Front Row Show. So click the link below to join that. And if you're new here, thanks for being here. Subscribe, and we will see you next time on The Slice Tennis News. Also, check out CourtsideSports.com where you can get 10% off brand new tennis gear. If you see a racket that you want to get, you're like, oh, I'm going to go pay $250 each for two rackets. Well, you could just do it online at this website, get 10% off, and then it'll end up being, you'll save you like $50, which is, so if you want to just save $50, buy your gear through here and use our code. And Bear Mountain, we have a vlog coming out from Bear Mountain on the clay where I'm trying to fix my forehand to make it look less like Benoit Paire's and more like Roger Federer. So let me know if you guys want to see more vlogs from me here at The Slice, and we will see you next time here on the channel. Thanks, guys.